This is the All Things Nerd Podcast, Season 4, Episode 30. On tonight's cast, we take a look at a bunch of trailers from Comic-Con at home, because that's where we're all at, is at home. We're also going to talk about how actors want to play other parts and rumors of actors that will be playing maybe the next big MCU, big bad, and then a couple Comic-Con games to go along with it. That and quite a bit more stuff to chit-chat about. So
you got this.
Enjoy the show. Here's the intro. Hello to all the Geek Enthusiasts and Nerd Aficionados. This is Mess5150 welcoming you back to another All Things Nerd Podcast live from Hall H. That's what it would have been. If
I'm apartment 207, dude. What are you talking about?
We would have had our traditional every year live from the Hall H line, but no, COVID happened, which canceled 2020. And so now we're all live from our living room, bedroom, closet, bathroom, wherever we're recording our recording space is. So yeah, we're here. Thank you guys for joining us and coming to check out the show. Make sure that if you want to catch any previous episodes that you head over to malice-corp.com. That is the website that fronts this podcast, that supports this podcast. Not sponsored, just the main hub for all things nerd. This podcast is recorded every Friday, 8 p.m. Pacific time, 11 p.m. Eastern on Twitch, twitch.tv/MaliceCorp. And you can find this podcast anywhere that you listen to podcasts as well. Yeah, with that, let me get into how we start the show. And that's a little thing that we call Get Your Geek. It's a little thing we call Get Your Geek On.
Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that.
Okay, getting your geek on is what we've been doing, or what the people here on the cast have been doing for the last week since you last saw us. Things that you should be checking out, things that you should be looking into, or things that you should stay far, far away from. It's also how we introduce who's here on the cast. We'll start right with the ladies, because ladies first. Aloni is here on the cast. What have you been geeking out on, Elle, since last we saw you? I think it was a couple weeks ago.
Yeah, it's been a minute. What I've been geeking out on are our lovely producer, Jack Malice, and his BFF, Newport kid, A.A. Ron, have written a novel, so I've been geeking out on copy editing this novel. Yeah, that's and volleying a bunch of messages from Mr. Malice about said novel. That's what I've been doing.
Which at some point will be available somewhere that you can purchase, and you should go buy it.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely. Amazon or wherever they put it. But yes, still first draft, so work in progress.
Also joining us on the cast, we have Super Hoovy and Freak. What do you mean geeking out, Super?
Comic-Con panels for the past 3 days, and which we talked about a good chunk of them yesterday. Today I started to watch the Archer panel. I finished the Walking Dead panel. I don't even watch the show anymore, but the cast is so funny that I always watch the panel anyways. And it was a really good panel. And then I also watched a cosplay one and something about Star Trek versus Star Wars that I thought was going to be like a fun debate, and it wasn't. And somehow it like devolved into the mental health of like Picard versus Luke Skywalker. And I'm like, this wasn't quite what I signed up for, but I'm playing World of Warcraft while I listen, so I'm not going to like turn it off. And then I've also been binge watching Lucifer. Finally started that, so
it's a good binge. Worst panel, best panel so far that you watched?
I think the worst panel that I watched was, what was the one that I said I tuned out of like halfway through? It wasn't a bad panel, but Duncanville, I didn't finish it. You know what? I turned off one from today. I started watching, where was it?
That's how bad it was.
I watched The Mandalorian and his mini gadgets, and also Charlize Theron's panel for her action movie career and the new series that she's starting. God, what was it?
It's forgettable.
It was that freaking forgettable.
It's on today. Okay. Yeah. I don't know what was everything that was on today. We talked about it last week. But the best panel for you was.
It's a toss up between His Dark Materials and The Walking Dead.
Okay.
Because both were really funny and really engaging.
Nice. And also joining us on the cast, we have Masonic Vader. What have you been geeking out on?
Oh, well, it's been a COVID summer for me over here at the house, and get my son caught up with all the great movies that have happened. So this week we watched Stargate, and I introduced him to Stargate SG-1. Unfortunately, 5 episodes in, the Amazon decided to pull that from their included in Prime. So, really? Yeah. That's the bane of my existence, man. I start watching a series, like I started doing that with Battlestar Galactica, because it was on Amazon at 1:20. I was like, yeah, I'm gonna get it. 2 episodes in, they pull it from freaking including in Prime.
They want you to be like the crackhead character from a Chappelle show, where you're just like, I just need a little more. Just give me a little more.
They ain't getting any more of my money. They get enough. All right, so we got 4 episodes in. My kid's like, oh, this is good, Dad. Let's watch another episode. And I'm like, okay. So I turn it on. I'm like, some bitch. So, yeah. And for everyone wondering why I'm in a suit, I'm the only one who's actually inspired by Comic-Con, even though we're not there. I am not Masonic Vader. I am cosplaying Obadiah Stane. If you're watching this on YouTube, he will be putting a picture of us next to each other. And you will see the resemblance.
Yeah. If you were going to hold up a picture of Obadiah Stane, I was going to be like, that's not Obadiah Stane. That's the dude. You're lying.
Obadiah Stane. Shut your mouth. Dude has long hair.
Drinking White Russian. He can't be the dude.
That was October.
Going to the chat room before we talk about my geek out. Cannon Fodder has been geeking out on Orville and Next Generation and GTA 5. Jack says this is the best panel of Comic-Con because we should be on Comic-Con at home if all the panels look like this.
Yeah.
Compared to some of the panels that I saw, yes, I think we are better than what's been on some of the stuff for Comic-Con at home. Kenneth Fodder, I heard today that G4 TV was coming back in 2021. Ooh, that'd be cool. They did want to know why you were wearing a suit. They want to know if there was a Mason meeting. Kat Sadal joins us in the chat room. Red Meat Pot also joins us in the chat room. And Pedopolis, what's going on, joins us in, says Masonic Vader going all Reservoir Dogs on Amazon. Yes, he's Mr. Pink. That's what it is. That's
word, homie.
We've just changed his cosplay. He's no longer Obadiah Stane. He's Mr. Pink.
I think I have too much hair for that.
And Jack Miles says he looks like an Undertaker, I'm assuming. I am staying within character. I do not dress up for Comic-Con. I am not going to dress up this year, not being at Comic-Con. So I'm just staying with what I do.
Well, that's not true, because if that's the case, you'd be in a backpack or sleeping bag in the line of Hall H, and I would be hosting the show tonight. That was the thing I liked about this cast, man.
You don't know. You don't know that there's not a backpack, the sleeping bag sitting on my hard floor here.
It's a good possibility if you're in the doghouse, if you did something wrong, easily, yeah. You don't even get the couch. You get a sleeping bag on the floor.
So, 2 things that I've been geeking out on. First, yeah, it's been Comic-Con. It's been Comic-Con at home, watching all the panels. I started on Wednesday. We actually started doing a little bit of live streaming here on the Twitch channel to talk about reactions of those. Unfortunately, one of the videos disappeared as there was I had a partner here, and he wasn't too happy about everything. So there was a lot of 4-month-year-old baby crying. So we ended up deleting that one.
F you, Dad. F you.
Pretty much.
Okay. Give me my bottle.
Yeah, exactly. That's basically what it was. And then I've watched panels every single day. I would have to say best panel so far, by far, funnest one to watch was Superstore, because they have a little like 5-minute video beforehand that really, if you've been to Comic-Con, you will completely understand the video. It makes jokes about like them turning their homes into Comic-Con. In fact, one of the actors, the actor that plays the guy in the wheelchair, he's like, so I got these nachos, and he's got the chips and cheese, and he's like, I took $20 and threw it down the toilet just so it would feel real. So,
Yeah. Wow. Absolutely.
Well, okay.
And how you make that more realistic is you wait an hour and a half in an imaginary line to get them. Exactly. And then even better is that when you're done with that and you get your nachos, you spend the next 20 minutes trying to find a piece of floor that you could sit on comfortably, which is really not going to happen without getting trampled.
Yeah. I wouldn't say this is the worst panel, but it doesn't have the same allure when you're watching it at home on YouTube. There's this weird thing about watching Klingon lifestyle at Comic-Con where people are acting out Klingon's mm-hmm. everyday life comedically. But when you watch it and it's just really low quality budget on a YouTube video, it just doesn't have the same feel as sitting in a room watching people do this. So that was the hard one to definitely watch. But other than that, most of the panels, if you're going entertainment wise, have been great. The Walking Dead ones were great. I haven't had one that was really boring that turned in anything that was on TV and film. So
clearly not watching the panels I'm watching.
The Bob's Burger one gets great because they actually do bring people to ask questions onto the Zoom call that are just fans on camera. And it gets really, really awkward when the fan starts singing her own song, asking Kristen Schaal to come camp with her. And then Crystal Schaal starts singing back to her and it gets a little interesting at that point. So yeah, you should check out the Bob's Burger panel. But that's it. That's what I got for you. Oh, yeah. Sorry. Second thing I've been geeking out on. A good chunk of us have been geeking out on this. There's an app called Duplicat, and it's a deep fake app where it takes your face and it puts it on videos or on GIFs or memes, and you could send them all over. So I do not make an attractive Selena Gomez or nope. Shakira.
I mean, it's really hard. You don't make a really good attractive much of anything, but, you know, hey, we'll go with those.
I look pretty good on Nick Bosa, so transferring over there.
Nick Cage.
You know what? The Nick Cage one wasn't bad either.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh. I remembered the really boring panel. Do not watch DC Day Home at One, or whatever it was called, Day One at Home. The so name? Effing boring. It made me want to cry and hate Batman. That's how boring it was. And I don't, but that's how boring these people were talking about Batman. I was like, I want to hate everything. Yeah, there you go.
To answer Red Meepaw's question, asked what the app was. It's called Doubly Cat. So Doubli Cat. Not a sponsor. But yeah, it is a complete waste of time for about 20 minutes where you try to find different memes. I mean, I did a pretty good Hulk Hogan.
It gets addictive. Oh, your yeah. Aquaman was pretty fantastic. So
thank you very much. Yeah. I mean, me and Jason Momoa, I was his trainer. I was a stunt double, you know, go figure.
Cannon Fodder is cosplaying as a podcast listener, I think he said. We're a fan of the podcast.
Aren't we all?
Jack Malice, yes, here's the crazy thing. Can't tell the difference between him and Gary Oldman. When you put Jack Malice's face on the Gary Oldman with the app, it looks like the same exact person.
It's like, so, Gary Oldman without the acting chops or the money.
Yeah, exactly. With that, let's get into the first little thing. Not a specific thing. You guys didn't know what I was gonna be throwing at you. Little quick, just discussion game. I want to get your guys' thoughts on some stuff. It is Comic-Con, so we're going with a little bit of a superhero themed activity here. There was a website, Polygon, that gave the 10 best weird superhero movies that are not Marvel or DC molds. And I just wanted to pick your brains really quick and see what you think are the best superhero films outside of Marvel and DC, if you haven't. God, and see if hard. You can get any of the ones on the list.
V for Vendetta.
A funny thing is, it's not on the list.
What?
I agree. Yeah. Who
does what? Oh, this list is already bullshit. Sorry, I'll call bullshit on your list. I couldn't remember that one, but the minute she mentioned it, I was like, well, damn, yeah, that's a good one.
So, yeah, there's one I could say could replace immediately on this list once I go through the list, but go ahead.
Is Spawn Marvel?
No.
It's not.
I thought it was DC.
No,
it's not either. It was Image.
He could be one.
Really?
Maybe. I don't know.
That's what you're going with?
Hey, if V for Vendetta
I was trying to think way outside
Spawn
the box.
Spawn is definitely not on there. Spawn is considered one of the worst superhero movies ever made.
I was trying to go way outside the box.
Outside of John Leguizamo, I think, who did fantastic as the clown, as the Violator. So, do you have any guesses?
Hellboy?
That's another one that I would think would be on the list. It's not. Wow.
You know what? Cut that list off. Just go right to what they said, because that's bullshit. Viva Vendetta and Hellboy? I'm not saying they're Some Oscar winners, with. But what the hell?
Okay. I'm going way outside the box then, and I'm going to pull from the Disney franchise. Are the Incredibles on the list?
No, but they did. I thought you were gonna grab one of them going out the Disney franchise. So
is it gonna be something stupid like Firefly because it was a movie as in Serenity, but
No, some of them are. I'm surprised you didn't go with the first one that's here on the list, because it gave us Chloe Grace Moretz and a fantastic kick ass.
Okay, I go with that. That's a good one.
Now
Priest starring Paul. Bettany?
No.
No.
There is, and I want to know if anybody's ever seen this, because Kenneth said Vader's about to ignite red because of this
list.
Let me
go find my lightsaber really quick, dude. Some bitch. Man, I get lied, dude. Keep going. Sorry.
All right. So I've seen one of this guy's movies, and it's an Asian director, Takashi Meeks, and he did a movie called Ichi the Killer, which was pretty good. But they said this is just as far out there as his other movies. It's a movie called Zebra Man. I have no idea. Never seen it.
Never heard of it. If anybody's seen it,
please let me know. Another one that I'm surprised made it on the list, Hancock.
No, that's not surprising. It was a pretty popular movie. I didn't say it was good. I said it was popular.
It was Will Smith, Charlize Theron, and Jason Bateman. Like, it wasn't...
Yeah.
Oh, I can think of another one. Watchmen.
No, because Watchmen's DC.
Oh, is that DC? I forgot. Okay, sorry.
Now, this one was his... the way he described it was his version of a superhero movie. I don't consider it a superhero movie. The one with Jet Li, where he was like,
oh no,
fighting all his other versions of himself. I think to get down to.
They put that on the list.
Yep.
No, okay, this list needs to stop.
Is Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles on the list? Teenage Mutant.
No.
Oh, see, come on! Not even the turtles.
This list is dumb.
Mystery Men fails.
Every level of list fails.
What was that one?
Mystery Men.
Okay, now I'm going to throw this out here, dude.
Mystery Men's a great film.
Now check this out. When that movie came out, I still like it. However, I almost got kicked off my indoor football league bus because we played that movie and everyone looked at me like I was about to get shot. Dude, it was... how are they going to put that on there and not V for Vendetta? Sorry.
I know why. V for Vendetta is DC. That's why.
Hellboy's not.
It was a Vertigo imprint. So that's why. Yeah.
Bullshit.
But yes, Hellboy, you're right. Hellboy was Dark Horse. So you're right. You're right on Hellboy.
Let me throw you guys a bunch of coins or something, because here's the movie that I haven't seen that I need to see, and I know I need to see it because I've gotten literally yelled at about it. Mystery Men. I have not seen Mystery Men yet.
You should. It's a
you
good
need
movie.
Yeah,
it's a
see good that movie. Film.
We've been planning on doing it, just never happened. It kept slipping through the crack. So my bad.
It's Ben Stiller, Hank Azaria, Paul Rubens, Pee-wee Herman,
Jimmy Garoppolo, William H. Macy. Oh, I know everybody in it. I just have not actually watched all of it.
I just put two and two together. I got the Disney film, The Rocketeer.
That is on the list.
Yes, hey, I got one.
There you go. I still don't know how the turtles are on the list.
The other Disney movie that I thought Super would go this aspect. I actually like this movie, Sky High.
Oh yeah, Sky High. Okay, so when I said Disney, that's where you thought I was going.
That's where I thought you were going.
Okay, no, my brain went to The Incredibles.
How many more on this list, dude?
Iron Giant.
Okay, that one's a
good
one.
Why is that not at the top?
It's not by number. It's just the list. League of Extraordinary Gentlemen, which I actually was not a fan of because I love the comic and I didn't like the movie version of it at all. And then
it wasn't bad. I like seeing Sean Connery in that role. I think he played that one pretty good. It's an eccentric movie though. It really is.
I love that our chat room is trying to figure out any of these. We got Green Hornet. That's not on there.
Oh yeah, Sky Captain in the World of Tomorrow. World of Tomorrow.
I like that was an interesting movie. It's not on there. The Shadow's not on there. Dark is not on there.
What about the one that Billy Zane did with the pink suit or the purple suit? It's like dang it.
Phantom?
Huh?
The Phantom. Yeah. No, that's not on there. The last one on there, and I don't consider it a superhero film.
Sin City? Is that on there? What's that? That was kind of comic-y. Sin City was like a comic book.
Sin City was a comic book, yeah. But it wasn't superhero. And I don't consider this superhero either, even though they have powers. But I love this movie. Highlander's on there. So.
Okay. Yeah. Weird.
I will go with three of the movies possibly on there. The rest of them is garbage. Hot garbage.
Yeah, that was very
hot
strange.
Garbage. That list was made with people who don't even watch movies. They just looked it up on Google.
When I saw it, that's why I wanted to. I'm like, I'm going to quiz these guys really quick and just see if they can get any of them on here because it is so just out there. And you had better choices than I thought that were actually outside of Kick-Ass and Rocketeer. Most of the movies
Iron
I like.
Giant. On yeah, there, so so Kick.
They should have had.
Yeah, Iron Giant, had Kick-Ass, the Rocketeer. You guys had yeah, absolutely. Yeah, I think they were. It seemed like they were going for movies that were off the pace, I guess, and not like I don't know big budget like what we're used to.
I feel like this is some dude's like random Reddit list. Who posted it? It was just like, this is going to be super deep and nobody's going to understand what my thought process was. It's so brilliant. And you're just like, bro.
End scene.
Yeah.
It just amazes me that, like, for example, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, not an Oscar winning performance or anything, but by far, it was the first time I really saw that a comic book, made their characters come out, like, people saw and they're like, oh, cool, it's Turtles. Because at the same, around the same time, I was going to say He-Man, but that movie, my dad loved it. It is a dumpster fire from a fan of He-Man itself. So,
yeah,
it's amazing that they couldn't get some of those names on there that really, I think, did a good job of after Batman kept the comic book movies going.
And Jack Katz says Power Rangers, which no. None of the Power Rangers movies are any good. Don't know.
They weren't even comics, though, were they? They were TV shows first. No, they were TV shows with no comics, though. It wasn't the whole premise is that they came from comics to movies.
I don't know about that. I don't know. I don't know if Iron Giant was I know Highlander definitely was not a comic book. It's just superheroes. It was just a superhero.
Highlander's
crap. Yeah. So
not on this list. No, not on this.
Okay.
List.
I was gonna say you don't.
No,
like
it's a great movie, just not on this list. No.
Okay. Okay. No. Whew. We were going to have words, man.
Bring that shit on.
The only one. all right. So let's move into what's been going on this week with Comic-Con. And that's just a whole bunch of trailers. So it's time for In a World.
In a city, in a town, in a world, they thought they had it all figured out. But there was one thing they didn't plan on.
This is our trailer reaction. Some of the big trailers that came out this week, just giving our thoughts and reactions to them. The first one is not a Comic-Con trailer. It came out before Comic-Con was happening, but still in the very, very much in the vein of nerd culture and geek culture. And that is Project Power. It is a Netflix movie with
Jamie Foxx
and Joseph Gordon-Levitt.
And
it's where it's a drug that people can take, and it gives them power, a superpower for 5 minutes, and people start utilizing it. What do you guys think on the trailer?
I liked it. I liked the energy that was coming from it. I like Jamie Foxx in the role. Gordon-Levitt also looked pretty good. That scene where he takes a bullet to the temple, and it's just got the effect of water or whatever hitting the skin and everything. That was good. My kid and I actually watched that trailer, and we were both like, "Hey, that's pretty good." I don't know if he's gonna watch it, but it was. I'm interested in it. It's what was that? What was that movie with Bradley Cooper with the pill?
Yeah,
Limitless.
Limitless on roids.
Yeah.
Limitless on roids for 5 minutes. Yeah, there you go.
Basically,
you took my mind.
Is that what you were gonna go to? What was
Like, hopefully it's better than that. There was another one with ScarJo? She was also taking some pill that could also make her, like, super think super well or something like that.
Was that the one with Ghost in the... No, not Ghost in the Shell. But that was a nice film.
It was another thing that, like, expanded their brain power, and she was, like, super...
Oh, Lucy.
Lucy, that one.
Yeah.
As long as it's better than those two. Like, and for some reason, the cops... And the like super whatever human thing, like bright. I'm like, hopefully it's better than that. Not that I saw that, but that did not look good at all.
It didn't play well at all.
Yeah.
Netflix was looking to make a franchise with it, and it just didn't do well. So
they made a franchise called a dumpster fire franchise.
The cat said, yeah, so original, not. He's bringing back some old 90s verbiage right there.
Yeah,
hated it. No, I'm just kidding.
Red Meepaw caught you with Lucy. She was letting you know that that's the
movie. I didn't look at that though. That just came out of the top of my head.
I know. So I think it looks good. It's Netflix. We'll watch it.
I totally agree. It's not original, but the actors that they picked in it and the special effects, it got my attention. Mm-hmm. We'll see. I mean, was it just a film? Was it a one-time movie or is it a series?
I have no idea. You never know with Netflix.
Yeah.
I mean, they could plan to do like 10 films and then they'll cancel it after two.
They'll just take like anything.
Series. Yeah.
You saw that South Park episode. They take anything.
And then they'll cancel them.
You get three
chances after the third season. It's done.
Well, they did one good move this week, but I should have said during my... geeking out part.
You watched it, so
yeah. I'll let it go for this week, I guess, because I already missed my geek out. Sad.
Cats wants to know: did anyone watch the Image comic trailer for Crossover? I have not. If that's a recommendation, Cats, we will definitely check that out. I will check it out after the cast. So, I just wanted to know if you had the opportunity to take a pill and give you a superpower for 5 minutes. What superpower would you want? You only got 5 minutes, though.
So flying would be bad.
Yeah. teleportation.
Teleportation?
Yeah.
That's a hard one, because teleportation, you usually have to see the place that you're going to, sometimes depending on the rules of the comic book.
I see the Eiffel Tower. Ding.
Yeah, exactly. Once I'm in Europe, man, you just hop on a train, you go everywhere, and then you fly home and you're good. I can come home from Europe. I just can't fly to Europe right now.
Because the price the prices should be they won't let us over. Never
no,
mind.
We're banned.
Yeah, we can't go to Europe. It's not that we don't have enough money for a plane ticket. We just legally cannot.
Yeah. So I'll teleport there.
I forgot about that aspect. You got something, Vader?
Well, it's a toss-up, and I know someone's gonna like it when I say this, but I think for 5 minutes I would go with super speed. Okay. I'd like that. Just
in 5 minutes.
Yeah, see what happens. You know, make a trip. Well, go around the world in less than 5 minutes. Grab a couple things on the way back. I mean, that's what they do in the comics. So you know, I might as well.
Here's where I see a problem with that is because your 5 minutes are up and you're still going, so your body's not gonna be able to handle that force. So either you're just gonna fall really bad, or Yeah, I don't know how that works. Hey,
no, see,
4 minutes and 58 seconds.
Yeah, exactly. You know, they did it in the movie where he's doing the super speed and Superman's coming. You know, so he's paying attention. So look, I got 5 minutes on my watch. I'm gonna start running around. At 4 minutes and 30 seconds, I run back home. There you go. Whatever I'm, it's like, it'll be like what's those shows though? The supermarket shows, supermarket suite. It'll be worldwide supermarket suite. How much I can carry in my hands in 5 minutes and be back. There you go.
Oh, you take your Comic Con bags.
Oh yeah, good point. I do have it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I will do that, and a shopping cart.
Before I get to Loni's power, Cannon Fodder, this is the mirror version of Vader tonight, and you can tell because of the suit. Kat says, make sure it's not a blue pill with a V on it for Vader. Jack says, you do gravity manipulation. Pete says, you are Bizarro Vader today. And Jack's greatest power ever is gravity manipulation. Super speed to clean the house, says Red Meatball. And yeah, that's what we got in the chat room right now.
I don't care if I have super speed or not. It's like, it's gonna take me longer than 5 minutes to take care of my house. It's like,
well, there was a pill to help with cleaning the house and something about Mary. You I will take it in a heartbeat.
Boom, take care of this, please.
Cannon Fodder also says teleportation, so does Kat Sadow. Eloni, what would be your 5 minute power?
I really like Rogue from the X-Men's power, where she can just suck the life force out of people. Yeah, no, I'd totally do that.
Yeah.
With the accent?
Huh?
With the accent?
Accent?
Yeah, she got that southern draw.
Oh, yeah, Anna Paquin. Ugh, no, I'd...
No, not that one. No, 90s.
Rogue in general has she's a southern belle.
Yeah, oh. The '90s. No. Hell, that wasn't even Rogue. That was bullshit Rogue. That's what that was. Oh, my powers! I can't stand it. Oh, I hated that. That was the worst mutant.
Pedopolis, super speed. Go back in time. Load up on Amazon stock. Come home.
That would be a DeLorean, right?
With that would, yeah, that would be my. I would be mind reading because you just get close to somebody that. Get a hot tip or something. Go down to the New York Stock Exchange and get some tips. So
go to one of the big guys' houses, Bezos or Gates, and just be like, "Hey, go ahead and transfer me so much money. Thank you. Bye bye." That's it. That's all you gotta do. Yeah. Don't take it all. Don't take it all. Don't be greedy or anything. You know, $5 million should take care of you, dude. You know what I'm saying? That's chump change, you guys.
Exactly. Okay, so that was the first trailer. Now it's on to the actual Comic-Con trailers. We got at some point we're gonna just be able to put this all together because everything we keep getting. New Mutants, let it be known that now it's August 28th that the film is coming out, and they said hopefully with their fingers crossed, but they gave us the first 2 minutes of the film, and I just want to know if you guys are excited or if it let you down.
For New Mutants?
Yes.
No,
God, I will. Go ahead. Sorry. No, you're good. Go ahead.
I thought it looked really good from the first 2 minutes. And then the little teaser trailer we got later too. Looked dark, looked creepy.
Okay.
I actually thought it was cutting room floor video. I did it hook me. Did not hook me at all. No, it reminded me of a souped up Blair Witch project. I get that.
Yeah. I want to know what Aloni's thoughts were on it.
Was that supposed to be like a sequel to Logan with the kid? No, okay. Michael Pena is an idiot. And I love Michael Pena, but when your entire town is getting destroyed.
Michael Pena? I thought that was the Hispanic actor that plays an Indian in everything.
Yeah, that was the guy that played. Yeah, he was an Indian and all like Windtalkers and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And like Flags of Our Fathers, but isn't his name Michael? What the hell is his name?
Michael Pena. I'm thinking is like the is are is they it, both Michael Pena? Because Michael Pena is the
that's a talking guy from Ant-Man. Yeah. All right, I will look it up. Keep going.
Look it up. I'm pretty sure it's him.
I'm looking it up.
If they are, but go ahead. Yeah, he's an idiot.
What's, Yeah, your entire town is getting blown up, and you don't really know what's going on, so you take your kid and put her in a tree, like, not even a mile away from where his all this stuff is happening.
His name is Adam Beach.
Oh, that's right. Okay.
Adam Beach.
They look the same.
Yeah, okay. Jessica, what are you trying to say there?
And, what's her face? Christina Hendricks. They look the same.
Who and Christina Hendricks?
Jessica Chastain. They're both redheads, right?
Oh, God, no. That's an insult to Christina Hendricks. Sorry.
Yikes.
No offense to Jessica Chastain, but...
Katy Perry and Zooey Deschanel. They're like doppelgangers, but...
All things nerd, but if you go back and watch the best ofs from previous seasons, you'll see how much Super loves Jessica Chastain. She
There is a love that cannot be named.
There's a clip.
Voldemort.
Yeah,
it's just there is something wrong with that woman. I don't know what it is. There is something wrong with that woman.
I like Jessica
too much. Like Christina Hendricks.
No, I love Christina Hendricks. That is.
What are you talking bad about Christina Hendricks?
No, I was.
Go ahead. I know what you meant.
Go ahead, Aloni.
Oh no, that was it. It was like you don't even get like a quarter mile in the woods and leave and go. Like, what are you gonna do, man? Like, that was a terrible game plan, and now that kid is on her own, so we have to figure out what the hell happens to her.
Yeah. Of course. Yeah. That's the whole point.
Katsudow says, just released this goddamn movie. He also said they did enhance the werebear look in the movie for like the eighth time. I liked all the little snippets afterwards that showed them like fighting the nightmare bear and things like that.
The teaser trailer later was better, I will say that. The
first 2 minutes I didn't like the voiceover was interesting, but I felt that actor, like his lines were not being delivered well. It may have just been my TV, but it didn't look like finished quality. Yeah.
He's not going to be in it very much, so.
Well, you saw him die immediately.
Yeah. I was more going off of the tone of it. I liked the creepy vibe that it gave off more than the dialogue, because it gives me hope that they're going to be following through with the original intention of the creepy horror, kind of effed up.
They definitely world. Said about they're focusing on. And they said what storyline in the panel, they talked about what story that they're focusing on, the Demon Bear saga. Yeah. Which if you've read the comics, then at that point, then you know exactly the tail end of this story. So I already know what's gonna happen. So
you know what I was expecting to happen right at the end of there? Is there was they're gonna do the Curb Your Enthusiasm ending like they do in all the other memes? Because it was garbage. All right, I mean. like I agree with Kat. Like they need to release this movie because at this point, I'm almost putting it up there with Captain America from like early '80s with motorcycle helmet and crazy shield. I mean, this is garbage.
Yeah, Kat's supposed to be a trilogy, but we'll not. We'll find out. We'll see what happens.
A trilogy
we'll
see. Of shit.
Let's see what happens. The highlight of the panel, though, was just the release of their emojis.
Yeah.
If you guys haven't seen them yet, those emojis are priceless. I mean, Wolfsbane, Arya's character, or excuse me, Maisie's character, is really just a 2020 mood. Big wide eyes, shocked face.
Is it like Twilight Werewolf? Twilight Werewolf?
No. Yeah. Oh, man, it was just funny.
Sparkly Werewolf.
It took the focus off of her damn eyebrows.
Vader's so negative. He hates just everything. It's Obadiah Stan. It's Obadiah Stan.
Obadiah Stan, first of all, thank you very much. And second of all, aren't we all just a little negative about this movie? All right, come on. This is 3 years over. If I was 3 years over my budget or 3 years over my – do you think I'd still have my job? I mean, technically, I don't really have one right now because I'm on summer break, but still, would I have my job? Hey, sorry, boss, I'll turn this in 2 years. I got to fuck it up some more.
Well, they kept saying things have kept happening that I keep pushing it back because of all this stuff that's going on. So, Kat says the movie probably won't be great, but with everything going on, don't be surprised this movie does well with audiences having lower standards, thirsty for something new. At this point, a buildup of so much stuff to come out, we're going to have like the greatest renaissance of theater releases because it's going to be like screw summer, big summer movies. It's going to be 1985 is considered the greatest summer of film. 2021 is going to end up just being considered the greatest year of film because everything keeps getting pushed back, that they're going to just have all these things stacked up on top of each other, all coming out in 1 year. And it's going to be bonkers. The trailer
looks so bad. I think it's going to debut on Pornhub. All right.
So
service is going to take it. All right.
Moving on to the next trailer. We got our first look at the Star Trek Lower Decks cartoon, which definitely has a little bit more adult vibe to it with the comedy. You got one of the characters was drunk on Romulan ale, and then she grabs a balik, whatever the name of that big knife is for the Klingon, starts swinging it around and cuts into one of the other characters' legs and cuts a chunk out of his leg. Yeah. So what'd you guys think on that one?
I'm digging it. I'm looking forward to it. Like I said, I think my dad would be loving it right now because it's, you know, there's so many, you've done so many things with Star Trek and you expect so much stuff from Star Trek. Like, you know, you expect a certain echelon about it or whatever you want to call it. And then you get this and it's totally awesome. It's totally something like that probably really does happen on the decks. Like, we don't never see those decks. All those decks they keep talking about, decks 16 through 36 have been wiped out and the shields are on. So those are all the people we're going to be watching. That's what it is. Every time you watch a movie, that's who we're going to see. Those are the people that they lost in the war, and there should be a memorandum after it.
Anybody else?
So I really enjoyed it too. It looks kind of like, I can't remember the name of the web comic, but it looks very similar to the
Player versus Player, or no, Penny Arcade. Drawing is very, very similar to Penny Arcade. Yeah,
yeah. I think it's that one, which is cool, but also kind of like what because it shows the like junior enlisted people, where most because Star Trek is based off Navy, you know, Navy hierarchy ranks and rank structure, so it's always about the officers. All the movies are always about officers. They never talk about the enlisted. And this seems to be like very, also for enlisted, it's like, yeah, a lot of weird stuff happens among, you know, junior ranks and stuff like that. So that's going to be interesting to see that we, you know, we finally have something about, you know, not the bridge and not, you know, the wardroom and all that. So I think that's super dope.
I have to correct you on something there. They do talk about the red shirts. It's just usually the ones that get taken out during the show.
Yeah. Yeah, they're not the main focus because everything's always about the officers. Like,
it's actually, you know what? No, the first Star Trek with Chris Pine, because they were all regular enlisted, remember? There was 10 minutes of that. The bar scene when they were fighting and everything, they were enlisted.
But they weren't like the main focus of it. That's the thing. It's always, you know, they were all, you know, lieutenant, junior grades, or even ensigns and up. Nobody cares about butter bars. Like, come on.
Because no one gives a shit about the guy who has to fix the engine or something. The only one they care about is Scotty. They don't care about Scotty's assistant. Scotty's assistant ain't doing shit. All right. Scotty gets all the credit for it. It's his engine, it's his show. No one cares about the guys who have to clean up afterwards. All right. So that's why it's great. It's going to be great. It's going to be awesome.
I think it'll be good. Awesome.
I'm on my mojo.
It'll be fine, but I didn't like the girl in the trailer at all. She was very annoying, very shrill, very all over the place. Gave me an instant headache the minute she started speaking. I was just like, if she's in this like as a main character, I don't know if I'm going to be able to watch it because it was so off-putting just to hear her talk. I just could have been something with my ears or what, but I was just like, oh no, like I can't. The guy was fine, like, but the minute that she came on, I just completely turned off and was just like, nope. So
Cannon Fodder says he's looking forward to it and he's not a red shirt. I want, because Katz makes a point that I see with it, but Pedopolis says the unseen decks are where they store all the red shirt bodies. Let's keep jumping. Kat said, if Roddenberry was alive, this would never come out. Star Trek is doing something fresh, not original, but banking off Family Guy and Rick and Morty humor with a Star Trek name. I will take a twist to that because, one, that's what you're going to have, the traditionalists of Star Trek that are going to hate this thing and be like, this is not what Roddenberry had in mind when he made, and I think it looks fun. I think it's, people really liked Orville. I mean, at first Orville looked like just a bunch of dick and fart jokes, but it got better as it went along. And I think what happened was CBS was like, holy crap, they're making something somewhat funny using the Star Trek brand. Why don't we do that so that we can get people to come pay for the CBS streaming service to come over here and watch it instead? And then lo and behold, look, Orville season 3 is nowhere to be found. It can't be found anymore. So I don't know what happened with that, but I think that's some of what may have happened, is they're trying to bank on that Orville fan base to bring them back over to watch this cartoon.
So. See, I agree with part of that, to where I do think Roddenberry wouldn't want to sell out Star Trek necessarily to get CBS ratings or anything. Because, yeah, Roddenberry did create this whole universe. And, yeah, it's I think that's the main difference between Star Trek and Star Wars, is that Star Wars was more of the gunslinger Western kind of film, whereas Star Trek made you think. However, I do think Roddenberry would look at this and even give it a shot, just because of what you just said, that Roddenberry usually does things different. And this is one of those things where I guarantee if he looked at it, he would be like, this is different. This is something unique that brings a different part of it. It's not necessarily tugging at Star Trek at all. It's just a spoof off of it that we know isn't real. Like, if Roddenberry were to make a movie, this would not be in it. Regardless, he can make an entire movie about the red shirts and none of this stuff will be in it, but I think he would still take a little bit of, hey, this is funny. This is something you can create from my characters, and it's not messing with any Star Trek timelines or any characters. It's just totally something else. If they start plugging in some of the main characters, let's say Scotty or something, then I think they're taking it too far. They got to keep it separate. They got to keep it on some ship that you've never heard of with some crew that you've never thought of. If they can keep it totally separate, then it's solid.
Yeah. And I'm sure they will. They're not going to, because that's what I said. It's not going to be on the Enterprise. It's some ship you've never heard of. Yeah. That's what they talked about in the panel and everything for it. So last little bit of trailers was actually a welcoming surprise in terms of how these trailers came out, because we talked about this panel being one of the bigger panels. The way I thought the Marvel 616 documentary series was going to be on the Disney Plus service was going to be each episode focusing on a specific character to give us the history of that character. Nope. It's an anthology series of different directors focusing on different kind of history, part of the history of Marvel for the 80-year history, giving us some really interesting aspects to look at. So they showed us two trailers. One was by Gillian Jacobs from Community. She directed the episode. Knew squat about comics, she said, but did a trailer based on the women of Marvel, meaning the people that help, that are women that make the comics, not the characters that are women. And you got a little bit of a taste of the episode talking about Kamala Khan, Miss Marvel, and, you know, being created by a Muslim editor and a Muslim writer. And then you had Paul Scheer, who actually wrote some Marvel comic books. Didn't know that. Paul Scheer is another actor that is also from the bunch of different comedies, but he did a episode about those weird odd characters that have been in the history of Marvel, like the Wizard or Typewriter, which just had type all over his face. I just want to know what you guys thought about the two different episode trailers for this series, and if it got you kind of more interested in what they got going on for this thing.
Anyone want to go first, or do I get to?
I'll go first.
Thank you.
So no, I thought they were really great as far as like kind of features on different aspects of comics, especially you don't have to do like a deep dive to find like the interesting cool facts about Marvel. Like they kind of compile them in a nice little, you know, packet of thematic things, like the weird bizarre, you know, typeface and the other swirly guy, whatever it was in that trailer. But no, it's really interesting. I think Disney is doing a lot of good kind of anthology things. Like, I don't know if you watched their like soundscapes or something, but it was ASMR Disney, and they it was thematic, and they had different scenes and without music, just of whatever. So they're doing really good at kind of little pockets of stuff. You don't have to watch all of it. You can watch one and kind of be good for a while, just kind of get an interesting new, little tidbit, a little morsel. So you're not binging it. You can come back to it later, or you can binge it.
Yeah.
Well, and like what you said earlier about how, like when you're looking at it and the different directors, it really didn't take Disney long to kind of figure out to start, like, I don't know. I saw the same thing, and the first thing I thought of is like, holy crap, they're going to try to do something again with Marvel pulling from the Mandalorian kind of idea. Because like you said, there's different directors doing different parts. And that's what kind of bugged me about it. Because I'm like, dude, come on. All right. You've got a great show in The Mandalorian. You've got a great idea and stuff. Don't start cannibalizing the ideas. Don't start throwing it in every other show, because you're going to find out that that's probably not going to work. That style of directing, that style of writing, that style of it's not going to work.
But it's everything. A documentary. It's not writing.
I get it, but this is the start, though, because this is what Disney does. Disney finds us something that works, and they beat it to the freaking ground, and then they dig it back out. They beat it again. And I mean, I like the idea that they are focusing on some of the other characters. Like, I just finished watching a series on there called The Future Avengers on Disney that had some of the other Avenger characters, like Ms. Marvel, Kamala Khan before she became Ms. Marvel, and everything. So it's cool that they are starting to focus on the next gen of the Avengers, because they have to, because at one point they are going to be some of their main characters if they continue the franchise. But I just really hope that they don't beat a process, like, because I don't want it showing up on everything, because then it's going to take away from The Mandalorian.
Well, and that's I think if you, because I sat through the panel where these trailers were part of, and when you hear the aspect of it, because it's a documentary series, so it's not like a scripted series, the taking different directors actually is a better focus for this than what you got with like Mandalorian, because they're giving these directors, what do you want to focus on? What do you want to talk? You know, Gillian Jacobs, I want to talk about the women behind the scenes. Paul Scheer, I want to talk about the weird characters and get people's thoughts on those. You know, it's letting each director, and because of that, you get different aspects. I mean, Paul Scheer brought up a point where he was like, you can do Spider-Man 8 different ways, literally, because different people looking at it in a different way. It's not just focusing on the character. It's 80 years of history. There's a lot to go about and focus on. So I don't know. I got a lot more excited for it when I saw these little trailers. It actually made me more hyped for it, but I understand what you're saying. Is that it?
Yeah, that was it. That was good. I'm good. Yeah. Yeah.
Hashtag no one wants to hear that from me, I guess. Okay.
There you go. Come on, Vader. Yeah. Thanks.
Okay. That's it for the trailers.
Did you have anything about that? Super? Did you get to see
it? I think it'll be fine. It's not my cup of tea, but I think it'll be fun for those that like that kind of thing. I'm just not an anthology. I can watch one maybe once,
in the documentary series. So
yeah, but yeah. I'm not a documentary series. Like it has to be something really intriguing. And I'm just so inundated with everything Marvel lately. It's just like, just need a break.
Yeah.
So,
okay. Yeah. So we're going to get into, the other stories. Cause that was what we had. There's a lot more Comic-Con trailers out there, but we're not talking about every single one that's out there, but you can go look and find them. We're going to get into the nerd news.
I haven't done it for a while, so I lost it.
First and foremost, talking about actors that want to play other characters that they've already played before. Well, they haven't played before. They're just trying to follow in the footsteps. James McAvoy was asked about if he'd want to play Picard, and because he did a little like fan film where he was Picard or something like that. And so they asked him if he'd want to play Picard, because he's already played Professor X, which was also played by Patrick Stewart. So, hey, why not? Let's have him go play every character that Patrick Stewart played that he was popular with. And McAvoy said he better get to play Picard at some point. If not, he will fund it and make the movie himself so he gets to play Picard. I just want to know, so you guys think of McAvoy, if in the future he gets to play a young Picard, if it should happen.
I would be down with one character. I don't want to see him redo everything. Just but I like McAvoy. I mean, I like pretty much all the things that he's been in, minus a couple of the X-Men movies. And that's more due to bad writing than bad acting. But I'm going to severely miss him this season in his Dark Material. So I think it would be fun. I mean, prequels can get kind of old sometimes, but... you know, in the right circumstance, it might not be a bad thing. But I would like to see it after Picard has run its course. I don't want to see Patrick Stewart doing his thing and then him doing his thing, because that's just too much.
What else? What do you get? Nope. Sonic, nope. Aloney?
Nope. Nope. I think one ball-headed actor played. I mean, I think one ball-headed character is enough for him. I think they need to find somebody else. If I was him, I wouldn't want to do it, just because I don't want to be that guy who has to do everything redone by him. I mean, because if that's the case, they might as well do Robin Hood Men in Tights so we can come out at the end and surprise us all as being King George. I mean, yeah. Some bit.
Don't be typecasted.
Yeah. Don't be his backup, because that's what he's going to turn himself into. He did a good job of Professor X, and I liked his version of it. I liked the younger version of it. He did a great job. I was excited when I saw him get the head shaved and in the wheelchair and stuff. Great, cool. Now I'm going to see him as Picard. No, I don't want to see him as Picard. I don't want it.
We can get the actor that plays a Beast to come along as Riker, get the blue beard on his face, and
hell no, he could be Worf. He could be Worf. Exactly. There you go. He could be Worf. And then, you know what? While we're at it, we'll go ahead and throw Logan in there. He could be Riker, and Deadpool could be Yar. I mean, come on, dude. I just stay away from it. McAvoy, you are a much better actor. You do a great job with your roles. You pick really good movies. Just keep doing that. Don't ride his coattails. I think that's what he's doing. He's going to be riding his. He will be. That'll label him. I guarantee if he does it.
Do you have any thoughts, Aloney?
What's that?
Do you have any thoughts, Aloney?
No. I like James McAvoy. I think, but yeah, to do everything that Patrick Stewart has done is be kind of weird. I mean, he could do it, but it's like. So I don't know if you guys saw that. Yeah, exactly. Why? Like Broadchurch, that show Broadchurch with David Tennant. So apparently, the same
character in an American version.
Yes, I just found that out because I'm like, no.
Well, they did try, because it's weird. Like a lot of times, British humor and stuff like that. Like I'm actually surprised Doctor Who is so popular over here. But like those old school British television shows, like they just don't translate over here to the mainstream culture. So they tried. It just didn't go as well as I had hoped, because I liked Broadchurch. I thought it was excellent.
Yeah, it was super good. But it's like you try to have an all-American cast, except the dude who played the main guy in the original. Like that just seems. Yeah. It's like when they made Straight Outta Compton. It's like all those guys except for Eazy are still alive. Like I think it's just kind of weird that they made a movie and they're not like super old either. They make
movies about people that are still alive.
I know, but it's weird. Or like,
there's transfer over of like when Rocky Horror Picture Show was made, you had actors from the Broadway play actually in the movie playing their same characters. Or it was the same thing with, was it Sound of Music? I believe that she was also playing. I can't remember which one it was. It was either Sound of Music or it was My Fair Lady, where they were playing that character on Broadway, and then they went over and played it in the movie as well. Sure.
I could see going from live to screen, like that makes sense to me, but like playing people who are still alive and relevant or playing the same character in a completely different production in the same medium, That's just, I don't know. That's just weird to me. But going from Broadway to screen, that I could see that.
Okay, I got a solution for it. I just thought of something really quick. All right, I will be down with McAvoy playing Picard if Picard comes around and plays the character in Split. I'm down. Totally down with that. If you can pull that off, Split and Glass. If you can pull that off, if we can get him doing that, I'm down with that.
You want to see?
Totally down with that.
You just want to see Patrick Stewart running around with no shirt on.
Oh, I could just watch that on Next Generation, dude. There's a couple episodes of that. There's I don't need that. Episodes, yeah. Sitting all cross-legged in his bathrobe. But no, Split and Glass, good to go.
Pedopolis says Vision can be Data. He also says James McAvoy can play Masonic Vader in the Malice Corp movie. There you go. So you got him.
Word, homie. Here. I like that. That's a good suggestion. Extra points there.
Jack let us know that the writer of Rocky Horror in the movie played this character in the play and the movie, Richard O'Brien. And then the rant. So we got a nerd rant redemption. The nerd rant that they want is about the 20th anniversary of Harry Dresden. And you got 60 seconds.
Gary Jones.
I can teach you how to rant.
I can't stand it.
It doesn't work that way, you know, like, so make it realistic. I mean, they were enjoyable to a point, but were they fantastic? By no means, no. I mean, I've seen worse movies, we're not gonna lie.
And I'm like, well, she spoke. She may have lived somewhere. Someone slid on a pole and there was a plane.
And now, another nerd rant with Super Hoovie and Free.
To give us your...
I love Harry Dresden. Why would I rant about this?
No, but I did you watch the panel? I don't know.
I did watch the panel. I mean, I guess the biggest...
Do a happy rant.
The only flaw, I guess, I saw in this panel is it would have been nice if he'd actually been, like, sitting up in a chair and, you know, not... Clearly, he was sitting, like, in bed or on a sofa or something like that, and, you know, he was totally, like... He had a bad filming angle, I guess, because it was, you could tell that his camera was like at below his chin and then shooting up. You know what? The moderator, like I think it was his editor or his beta reader or whatever it was that was doing it, someone that he knew. Way too giggly, though. It's like, come on, dude. Like, you know this person, you know this guy. You don't have to fake all that laughter. Just let it all flow naturally for you.
Keep the flow. Keep the flow. Keep going.
So the way that the panel was shot was kind of bad, but the panel itself was like really, really good.
No good stuff. Bad stuff. Pick on the lamp.
The lamp. Yeah. But it was a very poorly shot panel. Like, it just looks like they called him up as he was getting ready for bed and just been like, okay, hey, can we talk about this? Cause by the time this drops, it's going to be Peace Talks is going to be out. So let's do this panel for Comic-Con. And he's like, yeah, okay, sure. Let me put a shirt on and I'll sit in my bed and we'll do this panel. Like,
okay. At least he was nice to put a shirt on. I mean, yeah. All right.
First book in 5 years, Jack Miles says. But it's a book. It's a book coming out. Like George R. R. Martin, it'll be out eventually.
At least he had a good explanation. I mean, he had a whole upheaval in his personal life with his wife leaving him and a best friend dying and things like that. So he literally had to, like, take himself out, put himself back together, and then get back into the book writing. And he did it. And not only did that, but then said, I can't let my fans wait for another year. I'm going to do 2 books in 1 year. Boom. What do you say to that? And he is. And he's doing 3 books, actually, because he's doing his fantasy series for the Codex. So eat that, George R. R. Martin. Suck a dick.
Yeah, punk-ass Martin. Fuck
what you. What did you start, Kat? Okay. We've gone well beyond the 60 seconds for this rant. He definitely got his points worth on it. Yeah. Okay. Oh, good Lord.
Those sheets were not made, man. They were not made in that bed.
Let's get some happiness from Masonic, because everybody's talking about how jaded he is about on tonight's cast. The one thing that I think will make him happy is anytime you talk about Ewan McGregor and Obi-Wan. And
yes!
Apparently, yes. Apparently, Emilia Clarke is coming back to reprise her role from Han Solo in the series, and you might also get Natalie Portman in the series, probably in flashbacks, I would assume. This is in rumor format. So go. I want the happiness, Vader. I know that you love talking about Obi.
Hell yeah, dude. This is the movie we want. I mean, I'm kind of happy they've stalled, because now with every movie that's come out and everything they're doing, it seems like they're doing the same thing Mandalorian's trying to do with the series, and they're going to start interjecting things from the different movies as well. So you're going to have a Solo character. You're going to have a flashback with Padme. You might have a young Luke Skywalker, which I'm sure that'll eventually happen. A Darth Maul, possibly. I mean, this is starting to sound really awesome. Like, this is the movie we want to see, but now it's even getting better. So to see that they are going to have Emilia Clarke, that they are going to have possibly have Padme come back and do some flashbacks, I think that's great for the movie. I just want to see it happen, though, now. Enough talk. I mean, I don't want to have another freaking 2 years before I have to start New Mutant in this shit, too. I want to see this movie come out, but I do want to see a little bit more of the injecting of the different movies. I want to see this could be the possible, I don't really want, I think the connection, the fix to a lot of things, and I was excited to see that. And to go as far as even side note that they're even contemplating doing a second Han Solo movie. So there's a lot of stuff that came out of it this week. I'm excited. Yay, Obi-Wan.
But it's not a movie, it's a series.
Whatever, dude. I'm going to call it a movie because it should have been a movie, but I'll take whatever I get at this point, because Obi-Wan needs to happen. It's the one pure part of the original trilogy and going into the prequels that I think everyone really do agree was probably the best casting. And
but do you think, before I get into this actual aspect, I wanted to get Aloni and Super if they have any thoughts or opinions on it.
I like Ewan McGregor. I've been waiting for this series, so I'm glad that they're still going forward with it. But
Emilia Clarke, did you guys
see? I did see Solo. Okay. I thought she was fine in it. Like, was it her great? She's not the greatest actress to me, but she's solid and she has good chemistry with people. And sometimes I'll take that more over the world's perfect actress, you know, because chemistry can sell a lot. And I think that her, if depending on who she's working with, Darth Maul, right?
Yeah.
So I think it could be fun. I mean, they made Natalie Portman kind of work, so she can't do any worse.
What? Wow. Hate on the Portman.
You don't
Portman,
like Natalie
huh?
Portman either?
I love Natalie Portman.
Okay.
Yeah, I love Natalie Portman. She was one of the few things I actually liked about the original trilogy. So they made her work the prequels.
No, call those the original trilogy. Yeah.
The origin story of Darth Vader. There you go.
In the chat room.
in the prequels, sorry. And if they can make her work in steaming hot garbage, then I think that they can make Emilia Clarke work in something good.
Okay. you have any thoughts, Aloni, on those characters coming back to?
No, I think it'd be great. Solo wasn't my favorite of them all, but it wasn't bad. I definitely like Donald Glover in it. I think he's fantastic in everything that he does. I do like that they're still trying to. I like them kind of go away from the core group, kind of like the Mandalorian, where it's. The Star Wars universe is so huge. They have so much stuff to work with, but if they keep going back to like great story, great trilogies and all that, but I kind of like the one-offs, like loved Rogue One, arguably the best Star Wars movie in my opinion, but you know, and Solo 2 is kind of away from the main story of Anakin and Vader and Luke and stuff like that. So I'd like to see more of that.
Mm-hmm. Well, and I think that's what Obi-Wan's going to pull off, though. Obi-Wan is not going to be, from what we've talked about before, it's not going to be him babysitting Luke Skywalker. It's going to be what happened to him in the Tatooine Desert, Ghost, everything else. I mean, yeah, it's
the untold story.
Cats and Elsa, and Cats, thank you for the 100 cheers on the channel. This is their way to erase Force, Last, and Rise out of existence, focusing on prequels and pushing High Republic, which Jack says Cats nailed it. He also said, no, Rogue One is number two. But she said arguably, and I agree, arguably it is between Rogue One and Empire. I do agree the Empire Strike Back is the number one, but I can understand both ways with it. Pete Oppa says Wampa needs a movie. He's so underappreciated.
I saw that.
So
right next to Tauntaun.
Jack asks, what about Ice Cream Maker Man? He absolutely needs a movie made about him. Just
they
running.
They use his ice cream maker all the time.
Just running, yeah.
Once again, this is one of the things I think Disney's starting to see or get right with Mandalorian. As we've talked about, they're putting Darth Maul in Mandalorian. Well, some bitch, I guarantee Darth Maul is going to be in Obi-Wan now because of Rebels and everything like that. They've made a canon. So it's cool. It's like what they're trying to pull off with Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. and Marvel. Now they're starting to intertwine these shows they're going to be doing, plus whatever they're going to do in the future. Obi-Wan is going to be freaking phenomenal. I think it's going to be up there with Mandalorian, if not slightly better, if they could pull it off.
Yeah. Yeah, Kat says, in between Obi and Skywalker as a child, Darth Maul, back the possibility is endless. Cannon Fodder says it looks interesting. Jack says, I just wanted Darth Maul's actual death to be so much more. Which that's why I think you'll get his actual death in this series, because that's the Obi Darth Maul is a bigger thing. So
they can't do it though, unless they bring him back in. Because I was about to say, now since they're talking about possibly doing a Solo 2 movie, I mean that's talking about it right now.
Darth Maul at the end of Solo, so
so they can't kill him off before doing Solo 2. They gotta figure it out. They can't do it to me like that.
Pete says if they brought Cushing back as Tarkin, they can bring Guinness to end an Obi-Wan movie.
I really do think that when you look at, I think Ewan McGregor is probably one of the most perfectly casted characters as far as doing a throwback to a person. So you got Alec Guinness playing the original Obi-Wan. When you put them side by side, and what I mean all the way down to the mole and stuff, I mean, I think they did a phenomenal job in finding someone to play a younger version of him. And as you get old, I don't think you could do any better than that. There's no need to go do a Tarkin.
Yeah, I agree. But
I mean, they tried to do the Tarkin with whatever actor was in. Was it episode 3? Yeah, where they had that guy with the messed up cheekbones and stuff. It was supposed to be a younger Tarkin. That looked like garbage. The CGI Tarkin was much better.
Yeah, they had CGI Tarkin in Rogue One. So
yeah. But episode 3 Tarkin was garbage. So yeah, they found it in Ewan McGregor. Don't need to do anything else.
All right. Other last big nerd news subject. This one's rumor mill, so there's no confirmation on this. It comes from a site that drops a lot of, hey, we've heard this rumor, and our source, we believe them, but we don't know if that source is really legit or not. Owen Wilson's going to be in Loki. We talked about that, I think, last year, that he was cast. Wow. But yeah, exactly. Wow. But we didn't know what he was playing in Loki, and that's what everybody's been asking, is what is Owen Wilson going to play? What is he playing? Well, now the rumor mill out there is that Owen Wilson is going to play a major character that's going to step into the next phase and be the big bad for the next phase of Marvel films, and he's going to be King the Conqueror, which is very interesting because Owen Wilson, not known for really anything serious-wise, putting him into the aspect of potentially being the next big major bad for Marvel. Okay, go back to your negativity, Sonic, because I'm sure it's going to...
How to tank a popular franchise? Cast Owen Wilson as your big bad. I love Owen Wilson. I think he does great at what he does. No. Oh, I'm sorry. Did you have a differing opinion? Because no.
Well, he may not be known for drama and stuff, but he wasn't like the majority of Wes Anderson's movies, and they're not serious per se. They're definitely quirky, but not exactly a straight comedy like, you know, Meet the Fockers or whatever.
Yeah. The Royal Tenenbaums was a dramatic movie.
Yeah, exactly.
And he fit his role well, but it was still
not super villain dramatic.
Yeah, but it's not super villain.
It's more quirky drama than straight drama.
Yeah.
If it's a Loki film, like, is it going to be straight drama? Because that seems still like it's a superhero thing. They can still
Loki series is going to have its little mix of humor, like you get with Loki, but
they're setting him up to replace Thanos. And it's like, no. Big bad.
Thanos was nothing comedy-wise with the Thanos character. So
yeah, not so much.
And it makes sense for King of the Conqueror to be the next big bad with them messing with time. It 100% makes sense that would be the next big bad. But to have Owen Wilson as that character is where I think the miscasting could potentially be. But that's just me. So
first of all, they got to do a lot of CGI on his nose. So this is also shows you where Disney is, and this is where I'm going to lose it here. Hey, we fucked up Star Wars. So let's fix it by doing The Mandalorian. Oh, cool. Now let's do Obi-Wan. Oh, Marvel. It's not enough movie. Let's put Owen Wilson as a baddie. Are you effing stupid? I mean, the closest thing that I saw him being any type of a badass was behind enemy lines. And even that movie
was so fucking awful. I mean, Jesus Christ. I'm going to run through the woods. I'm going to have 50 people shooting at me as I run through the woods. Not a bullet's going to hit me, but I'm going to turn around and I'm going to shoot my little pistol and I'm going to peg a guy between the eyes while he's 20 feet up a tree. That bullshit.
Hey, it was based on a true story.
I sincerely doubt that particular scene. I sincerely believe that there was someone running through the woods, and I sincerely believe that he was being shot at, but I do not believe that person turned around with a little pistol and pegged someone 20 feet while he's like this, not even looking, and pegged someone. No, that's Looney Tune level bullshit.
I'll put it this way. If they ever do make a Malice Corp movie, I am definitely going to make sure they say I'm in a professional studio when we do this show, not in my bedroom in my crappy apartment. Okay.
Yeah.
So going to the whole thing though, I mean, Owen Wilson has his glit. He has his niche, his little nick, you know, his, if I'm going to go watch him in a movie, I'm going to watch him make goofy movies and some sort of maybe rom-com movie or whatever, because he's some kind of a surfer.
He can do an indie film.
Slightly stoned personality, you know?
Yeah, he can do an indie film. I watched him, and again, it was a comedy base, but I watched him do a movie called The Darjeeling Express, where it's like him and his two brothers, I don't remember who played the two brothers, they take a trip across India to honor their late father's wishes, and it's basically a series of catastrophic events that follow them on this train ride. Yeah. But it was still like a good, it had a good heart to it at the end, so he can play an indie role, but again...
That was all Wes Anderson too. The Darjeeling. Yeah. That was Adrian Brody and Jason Schwartzman were the brothers. So he can. I mean, Bottle Rocket, Royal Tenenbaums, Darjeeling Limited. I think he did. I think he had a voice in Fantastic Mr. Fox. I'm not sure. He can. It's not the same type of seriousness. He can do it, but it's got to be not a villain.
So let's put it to you this way. Okay, there are three main baddies that they've had recently: Ultron, Thanos. Well, that's about it. Those are the two most major ones. In other words, CGI wise, okay. And you take the voices to them. Spader playing Ultron was perfect. That was exactly the type of voice characters you needed for that type of character itself. Brolin playing Thanos, great job yet again. I thought his personality, his voice, everything went well.
He actually acted it though. It wasn't just
I got you. But I'm just saying when you're using the CGI and everything, take those voices and then change them to something goofy.
Wow.
I don't know. I mean,
they're going through time. Wow. They're actually gonna.
Wow.
Oh my god. Wow.
I mean. They gonna seriously use a voice modulator.
I'm gonna go get me a license. I'm gonna join the Screen Actors Guild and I'm gonna put my name in it. I'm gonna do better at freaking Kang the Conqueror than that freaking douchebag. He hasn't done a good movie since whatever.
Last things before we move on to stuff from the chat.
The title you're looking for is Shanghai Knights Masonic.
Oh my god.
No, he did something
after that.
I don't know if he did the Conqueror's title.
What? If King of the Conqueror's main henchman is played by Jackie Chan, I'm all in.
Would that be MODOK? I mean, Jackie Chan is MODOK. There you go. He does all of his own stunts. So, I mean, no, come on. Disney, don't fuck this up, okay? You almost fucked up Star Wars. You got saved because you brought in the beginning of Marvel as far as
Feige. I'll have faith in Feige. Hopefully, maybe they'll put him somewhere else.
Oh my god!
If anybody wants to clip this stuff, you're more than welcome to
clip. I thought it's getting all riled up. Like this hasn't been like confirmed. Confirmed. It's a rumor.
It's all rumored. Yeah,
it's gonna be a rumor because if it comes real, I'm coming for someone's ass. I mean, this is crap.
Kat Siddell said, I don't think they're going to use Kang as the major villain, still leaning towards Galactus, but realistically will be Hickman version of Secret Wars as Dr. Doom is the main villain. Jack says Kang was kind of a weird character. They were very excited about Super's rant. Can Owen Wilson play in a Stranded Deep movie?
Pete, you put that shit away, dude. Owen Wilson is Obi-Wan. I will beat your ass for that one. Don't jinx it.
Wow, Luke.
No, don't jinx it. But go,
picturing but here, Sonic outside of like Disney Marvel with like that Eric Andre meme. Let me in.
But I do want to make one actual serious point though. Kang the Conqueror might be the baddie for the next, but it's not going to be the ultimate. Galactus will show up, but Kang's going to be the setup for Galactus. I mean, we have to remember that this series, this franchise, is not going to finish with the next Avengers role. They're going to do one more set, which is probably going to finish off with Galactus, and I could see them bringing everyone back for that one. But, you know, anyways.
Yeah, and Jack's trying to rile up Super by bringing up Buck Lemming, but he couldn't think of the name. So
there you go, yeah.
Hey, we do it with Nick Cage and Jack, so, you know, you get to hear Buck Lemming. So, yeah. So, okay, last thing. Somebody's got to talk about it.
We need to talk.
You talking to me?
Oh my god! Who told you?
Have you told anyone else about this?
What you talking about?
Look who's talking.
No, somebody's got to talk about it is the weird, the odd, the strange stories that are out there that somebody's got to talk about. There's a big name actor that is going to be putting out a comic book. And because of that, they put out a list of all actors that have worked on comic books. Are actors that created their own comic books, and I wanted to just quit and see if you guys can get them. So the first comic book was simple, but it was Space Force was the name of it by Tidal Wave Publishing. I was going to go through IMDb and give you guys the name list of what the actors have appeared on until somebody could get it, but I can't go through this actress's portfolio because her stuff doesn't appear on IMDb because it is of adult nature.
So, it's on the adult IMDb, whatever. Yeah.
So I'm just going to jump right into it and just say, just to give you guys, Stormy Daniels made a comic book. Yeah. So
what?
Yep. What? That's one of the people that's made a comic book. So, yes.
Oh my god! Can you imagine? Oh, dude.
It's titled Stormy Daniels. Space.
It's
Force.
It's like heavy metal on serious drugs.
Okay.
And
next
and
person that made a comic book.
And probably some next kind of syphilis book. Stuff.
It's gonna be really, really, really simple. They have been in going from the very beginning of their career. Butler's Night Off, Space Command, Howdy Doody. You just say your name once you think you know it. Playbill, Scope, On Camera, Goodyear Playhouse, Oedipus Rex, The Kaiser Aluminum Hour, Omnibus, Studio One in Hollywood, The Brothers Karamazov, Suspicion, Climax, United
that
States.
That was a Stormy Daniels.
Encounter, Outlaws, Thriller. I get up to where people would know this stuff. Dang it. Twilight Zone, 77 Sunset Strip, Channing, Route 66, Alexander the Great, The Outrage, Man from U.N.C.L.E., Defenders, For the People, Dr. Kildare, Gunsmoke, Star Trek, The Original Series.
William Shatner.
Thank you.
I don't know. You kind of lost me at the beginning because you said something Space Command. And for some reason in my head, I had stuck in the old 80s game Missile Command in my head for like a minute. I was like, dude, someone's doing a movie on Missile Command? No way.
No, he did a Tech Wars comic book is what he created. So that was the comic book that he was behind. This actor is known for, I'm just going to go by the known fors then. This actor is known for Heroes, This Is Us, Pathology, Killing Season.
Sylvester Stallone's kid in Rocky.
That guy. How do you say his last name? Ventimiglia? Ventimiglia?
There it is. That's cool. Yeah. He made a Top Cow comic book called Berserker.
That I might actually read.
Another person I can't put up because she would not have, she'd have listings. Jenna Jameson had a comic book.
Well, she's got listings, yeah. She's on that other one again. That was Climax, right? Maybe they did a collaboration.
Yeah, exactly. This actress who had a comic book that she helped write is known for... Come on, this is going so slow. Known for Rent, the Lego Batman movie...
Super Hoobian!
Rent?
Oh.
Rent?
Rent.
What the hell is her name?
Eagle Eye, Clerks 2.
Jesus Christ.
They know. Wait, what was the beginning?
Jane the Virgin.
Gina Rodriguez is the only.
What was the second thing you said? Rant and then what?
Rant. Lego Batman movie. She was the voice of Batgirl, Barbara Gordon, Eagle Eye.
Men in Black 2.
Oh, is it the girl that plays Thor's assistant or whatever? Valkyrie? No.
No, it's not Valkyrie. No. Looks kind of
Jane the Virgin. She was in Luke Cage. She was in The Defenders. She was
She's
Mexican or Dominican, I think.
She was in Sin City.
Oh, Rosario Dawson.
Rosario. I knew it was a rogue something. God damn it.
Diablo's got it.
She's in NBA 2K, too.
She also wrote a comic book. Just to give you an idea of all these people that wrote comic books. This guy's known for Pulp Fiction, Snakes on a Plane.
Nick Cage, Samuel L. Jackson.
Wow.
I just want to say Nick Cage right at the beginning.
Yes.
Nick Cage on my fucking plane.
I just love finding out all these people. I mean, it is Comic-Con weekend, so I just love finding out all these people that are actors that you would never thought have written comic books. This actor is known for many Monty Python films, as well as A Fish Called Wanda.
John Cleese?
Yep. Wrote a comic book.
John Cleese. That would be pretty good. As long as he didn't draw it.
This actor is known for... the All Things Nerd podcast, as well as National Treasure, as well as Gone in 60 Seconds, as
Samuel L. Jackson, Nick Cage,
wrote a comic book.
I believe it.
This actor is known for Batman animated series, for Star Wars.
Oh, Mark Hamill.
Thank you.
Sorry. Okay. I saw you look right at the camera. I was like, all right, cool. I got you.
This all came to precipice because writing a comic book coming out this year, this actor is known for Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure, from Matrix.
Keanu Reeves is
co-writing a comic book.
Yeah, his character looks like himself.
Exactly. The character in the comic book looked like Keanu Reeves.
He's using
careful. Beautiful.
So, that was the somebody's got to talk about it. So that's it. Yeah. It was. I mean, do you guys have any thoughts on Keanu Reeves writing a comic book with the character looks like him? And I mean,
hey, if I had the time, I'd do it. I mean, I'd need the money first, and then the time would come with it. I'm totally down with that.
Yeah. I mean, I guess comic book characters are usually idealized versions of whatever. So if he thinks he's the idealized version of himself, then hey, go for it.
Yeah. So that's it. That's all we got for the cast this week. We went long. Thank you to everybody that came and checked us out and hung out with us. And we hope that you enjoy the rest of your Comic-Con weekend. Let's talk about where you can follow everybody outside this cast. Aloni. there's not really anywhere to follow you, but
no, I want to make my stalkers work hard to find me. No, I'm kidding. Not my stalkers. I hope. No. Yeah, I don't really do. We're working on a podcast. We might try and pick something up later eventually, but yeah, no, check out malice-core.com, right? I don't even know the website. Wrong. That one, check it out. Make sure you give some love to all the other podcasters on there and such. But yeah, hope everybody.
Have you watched Aliens yet?
Katz is asking in the chat room.
No,
so she got Mystery Men and Aliens on the list.
Yet. Working on it.
You know, we are in a pandemic right now where you're not supposed to travel or do anything, so it's a perfect time to do it.
I still have work.
You got the weekend. Shut your mouth.
We're finishing up. Okay. Okay. Super, where can people follow you outside this cast?
You can follow me on Twitter at SuperHoovyAndNut, and you can follow me on Instagram at SuperHoovyAndFreak.
And Masonic voice. Vader, where can people follow? She's so somber, I know. Where can people follow you outside voice. This cast?
Masonic Vader 71 on the PlayStation Network. Just send me if you do follow me, just send a quick little thing about Malice Corp and Masonic Vader on Twitter, and soon to be another Facebook thing pretty soon, which we'll talk about probably next couple weeks.
Nice. You make sure to follow this cast anywhere that you listen to podcasts. You're subscribing, following, reviewing YouTube, malice-corp.com. Thank you for coming along. You can check us out on Facebook at facebook.com/groups/allthingsnerdpodcast. It's all streamers supporting each other. So if you've got a stream that you want to have people check out, come on over, be a part of the group. Let us know what you stream and what you have over there posted there. If you want to follow me, you can follow me on Twitter at @mest_malicecorp or on Instagram at @mest5150. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for coming along and having a ranting good time talking about all the stuff that went on this week in the world of nerd, geek, and pop culture. We will see you next Friday on Twitch, twitch.tv/MaliceCorp for the All Things Nerd podcast at Friday at 8 p.m. Pacific time, 11 p.m. Eastern. You keep nerding on. Good night.
Say no to Owen Wilson.
Wow.